A new study with surprising findings when it comes to the use of controversial stun guns.
While they can injure you, West 2's Greg Fox reports new research shows the devices could cause fewer injuries than other types of force when arresting suspects.
More than 16,000 police agencies use stun guns. Former Orange County Sheriff Kevin Berry made national headlines in 2004 when he volunteered to be stunned, showing he was not seriously hurt. This is perhaps the most viewed stun gun incident in history, with 6 million views on YouTube. The arrest of UF student Andrew Meyer in 2007 during a speech by presidential candidate John Kerry. He wasn't badly hurt, but some have died after being shocked.
Now a UCF researcher has come up with several studies that look at the use of stun guns by police across the country and how many times officers and citizens are injured.
Dr. Eugene Paolini researched nearly 2,600 incidents from 8 police departments that involved stun guns. He found the devices protect officers, but with risk to suspects.
If you're willing to take on some of those citizen injuries, and knowing that in many cases it's going to reduce the probability of your officer being injured, that's what police chiefs should be dealing with.
In cases where officers used only a stun gun, 41% of suspects were injured. But in cases in which they used stun guns along with batons, pepper spray, or their hands, suspects were injured more often, 47% of the time. The same study found officer injuries to be 6% when only using stun guns. But officers were injured 15% of the time when using other means to subdue suspects. While UCF police rarely use stun guns, they say the new information could help them to adjust policies.
If we're given that opportunity, certainly we'll look at that and we'll make some decisions if necessary.
UCF is now looking into the effectiveness of stun guns in getting suspects to comply. Greg Fox, West 2 News.